Hi, welcome back everyone. Before we get started, I just want to tell you that if you like movies recaps like this, please join our small family by subscribing to the channel to receive more videos like this and help me to grow, and I will post every day a new video, so I really need your support to continue, and I really appreciate that. So please subscribe, and let's get started. Today we are going through a 2018 horror film called Secret Santa. The movie starts with a few people who are fighting on Christmas night. Then, 4 hours earlier that fight, a girl named April is going with her boyfriend Ty to dinner at her mother Sherry's house. When they arrive there, April introduces Ty to Sherry, who takes them to their room. She apologizes to them for not giving them separate rooms as she is expecting some guests at her house tonight. April gets a little upset because the room has bunk beds, which she doesn't like at all. But Ty tries to cheer her up and he tells her that they will manage. April and Ty get ready for dinner and go downstairs where they meet Sherry's friend Carol. Sherry offers them a drink, but April refuses as she does not like being drunk while Ty drinks it for Sherry. Then Sherry collects their mobile phones in a big bowl. April tells Ty that this is a rule of her mother's house when she calls for dinner. After that, April's younger brother Kyle and elder sister Penny show up. April is very happy to see Penny and she introduces her and Kyle to Ty. Her brother Jackson also comes there with his girlfriend Jacqueline. All the family members are very happy to get together at Sherry's house. Then their father Leonard also shows up and all the siblings are delighted to have him at the party, but Sherry doesn't like him and she tells him that he cannot attend the party or else she will call the police. Leonard doesn't listen to her and tells her that she cannot stop him from meeting his children. Next we see Sherry's brother Carter appears at the party and he grabs a drink. Right after that, Sherry calls everyone for dinner. She has cooked a delicious turkey for the whole family. At the dinner table, Leonard tells everyone that he missed his children a lot while he was away from them. Sherry mocks him and she tells him that he has never treated his children with fatherly love and it has always been Sherry who looked after their children. Kyle asks Yaa and Jacqueline about where they met each other. Jackson accidentally reveals that they met at a strip club. Penny is allergic to turkey so she doesn't eat it, which angers Sherry because she thinks Penny is just exaggerating the matter of her allergy. Penny explains to her that she found that she was allergic to turkey when she ate the meatballs at school, after which some of the friends stole her trip ticket to Europe. Sherry then points out April, who doesn't drink because she thinks she hurts her loved ones when she gets drunk. Sherry, Penny, and April argue with each other where Sherry accidentally hurts Penny by saying that she is fat. Then April comes up with an idea of playing Secret Santa where the contestants will get Christmas gifts and they will have to guess who bought them those gifts. The first contestant is Jackson and Jacqueline, who get a book and a necklace from Sherry. After that, Carol gets her gift that turns out to be two tickets to a concert in London. Next, Ty calls the next contestant, April, and he then proposes to her with a beautiful ring. Later Ty reveals that the real contestant was Penny, but he took April's name because he wanted to propose to her. Then, Penny gets her gift and she finds tickets for a trip to Europe. As Penny wonders who bought her the tickets, April tells her that she is the one who bought them. She also reveals that she knew that the meatballs were made up of turkey and she let her friends steal her trip tickets. She apologizes to Penny and tells her that buying her trip tickets is the least she can do for her to compensate for what she did back then. Penny becomes very angry and Sherry scolds her for using abusive language. While arguing with Sherry, Penny reveals Sherry's and Jackson's affair. Sherry asks her to get out of her house, but Leonard reminds her that he is also the owner of that house. Frustrated, Sherry reveals that Leonard slept with Carol. Leonard shouts at her and he tells her that he is just not like her who slept with her stepson. After this, Carter comes at him angrily, telling him that Jackson carries Leonard's bad traits. Sherry stabs Carter with a fork in his neck and everyone breaks into a fight. Frustrated, Penny attacks her stepmom Sherry and they both fall to the ground. April reaches for the big bull to get her phone, but Penny pulls her leg while Jacqueline gets the ball. Penny attacks her and she destroys the phone's bowl by spilling the drink into it so that no one can call the police. Carol finds Carter dead and Jackson tries to release Leonard, who is caught by the caterers, while Jacqueline is threatened by Penny with a knife on her neck. When Jackson attacks Penny to let go of Jacqueline, the caterers fight with Leonard. That angers Jackson and he beats them. Kyle, who is gay and he has an affair with one of the black caterers, hops on Jackson's back to take revenge for beating his boyfriend. Jackson somehow gets rid of him and then he gets knocked out by April with a pan. After that knocked out, Jackson, Leonard and dead Carter are taken into a room by the family members. Then they decide to go to town and get an attorney for Leonard, but they find that their car's keys are stolen. Penny, who is tied to a chair, reveals that she has stolen the keys and she has put them in the back bedroom where Jackson, Leonard and Carter are together. After a while, the family comes to know that Kyle is gay and he has an affair with one of the black caterers. They go to the back bedroom to get the keys, but they find that Leonard and Jackson are awake. April tries to ask Leonard to slide the car keys under the door because she wanted to go and get help for him, but she freaks out when Leonard slides Carter's finger under the door. As soon as April and other members enter the back bedroom, they find that Leonard and Jackson have escaped the house through the window. Right after that, April decides to go and get help from the neighborhood. Ty and Jacqueline also go with her, and April asks Kyle to keep an eye on Sherry while they go outside to get help. Ty, April, and Jacqueline find Jackson and Leonard outside the house and they hide. Carol tells the caterers that if they get her car keys and get her out of that house, she will reward them with a lot of money. The caterers get excited and set out to find her car's keys. While the caterers find the car's keys outside the house, Sherry and Carol break into a fight and they taunt each other for their affairs. The caterers look for the car's keys and Kyle's boyfriend finds them, but as soon as he is about to grab them, Leonard appears and stabs him to death. In the next scene, Carol and Sherry continue fighting with each other while Penny enjoys watching them. Ty, April, and Jacqueline arrive at a neighbor Denise's house. April tells her that her phone is dead and she has to call the police because her brother and father are sick. At first she refuses to help them because she says that Sherry is a very unfriendly neighbor. But then her husband Albert comes and he tells them that he will get them the phone to call the cops. Albert and Ty get into an argument and suddenly, Jackson shows up and he kills Albert with a shovel. Then, he kills Ty by decapitating him. Jacqueline and April freak out and run away from the spot. Sherry stabs Carol in her stomach, and then Carol hits her against the Christmas tree. She attempts to strangle Sherry, who hits her with a Christmas tree bulb on her face and she falls to the floor. Right after that, she gets up and stabs Sherry and then she leaves the house. One of the black caterers finds the female caterer, Tilda, who has found the car's keys, and she is listening to the last rap song that Kyle's boyfriend sang. As the caterer talks to Tilda, Carol attacks him from behind and kills him by hitting the car's door. Tilda kills Carol by stabbing her with the car's keys, and then she continues listening to music. While running away from Jackson, April and Jacqueline try to get into a car in front of their house, but suddenly, April finds Leonard's dead body and she bursts into tears. As Jacqueline consoles her, Tilda appears to vomit blood until she dies. Jackson approaches April and Jacqueline with Ty's head in his hand. Jacqueline and April run into the house where Penny and Kyle shut the door before Jackson could get inside. After that, April pushes Penny next to the wall and she asks her about what she had put in the drink that made everyone become sick and mad. But Penny doesn't tell her anything, so April gets her a cup of the drink, but Penny doesn't drink it. April asks Kyle to bring Penny's bag and she finds a few bottles of medicine in it. Then Penny opens up and she admits that she mixed a powder in the drink that makes people say the truth. She tells her that she wanted the family to speak the truth at night and she wanted to know if they all really loved her. She also tells April that she did not know that the powder would make them sick and mad to such an extent that they would kill each other. Right then Jackson shows up and attacks them, but Jacqueline fights him and eventually kills him by twisting his neck. Suddenly, Jacqueline is attacked and killed by Sherry with a sharp Christmas tree bauble. Kyle also becomes affected by the powdered drink and he attacks Penny, vomiting into her mouth. Penny becomes unconscious and April lays down with her on the floor. The next morning, April wakes up and stands on the balcony of the house. After a while, Penny attacks her from behind, but April cuts her finger with her teeth and throws her from the balcony. As she watches Penny down on the snowy ground, she screams in grief. In the last scene, we see a family going in a car to that area. While the family members chat with each other, they stop as they encounter April in front of their car. One of them, named David, gets out of the car and sees April, who is covered in blood, and she murmurs something. David asks her if she is all right. He offers her help, but then he notices that April is stabbing herself in the leg with a fork in her hand. David's wife warns him to get away from her, but in the meantime, April attacks him and the movie ends here. Do you still want to celebrate Christmas with your family? Let us know in the comments below and don't forget to subscribe to receive more videos like this. Thanks for watching, guys.